What's up, everybody? Count Snakus back at you again today. How many of you guys have heard of a chase figure before? There's lots of things that you could chase after in your life, but as an adult toy collector, chase figures either are a blessing or they're demonic and drive people insane. A chase figure, if you don't know, is a hard-to-find action figure for whatever reason. It could be because, say, maybe Hasbro short packs their boxes like so many other toy companies have done with a certain figure, the one figure that they know everybody wants, let's just say, and maybe, like I said, maybe it's just one figure per case and you can't find it, or maybe they don't even put even a figure in a box, let's just say, maybe there's one figure in every other box. Pretty weird things, it's hard to find. So that could make a chase figure. So because of the high demand, there's not too many of them, so they're hard to find. And then hence you go onto eBay and you spend millions of dollars for one damn figure. But then again, a chase figure could be created just because of the high demand, popularity of the figure, and maybe said toy company is making plenty of these figures, but you still just can't find it. So that's what a chase figure is, and of course its value increases. And then eventually some of these chase figures, after the hype has gone away and people can start finding them again, this value goes way down, probably where it should be in the first place. You know, over the years, there's been plenty of chase figures, way too many. I mean, currently now, there's this one right here. There's the Hasbro Mandalorian figure in his carbonite outfit, sparkly outfit, that I have no intent of trying to find. I have a Mandalorian figure, just the regular one. I'm happy to have it, and that's all I need. I don't need this one, but this is a chase figure. All the Star Wars collectors, most of them, the adult collectors, really want this, and a lot of people have not found it. But if you want to buy it, you can go on eBay now and spend way too much money for it. And is there ability to have a chase figure in the world of the vintage toys? I guess there is. You could say that vintage toys obviously are toys that are no longer being made, but there are the variants out there, like this right here, the blue bearded Stratos from Mattel's Master of the Universe toys that came out in the early 80s. So if you can get yourself a Stratos with a blue beard, you're very lucky. I don't have that yet. One of these days I'll have myself one. So, but we're gonna get into the world of Mego right now. That's right, Mego. You guys know I love Mego. I know you guys love Mego too, but they did do a chase figure. I don't know if they meant for it to happen, but it did happen. And this figure, you can only get it in a full case of their 14-inch figures. You know, Mego does make 14-inch figures. And this is the last wave that they did with 14-inch figures. And what we're talking about here is Black Manta from the Aquaman comic book. And I don't think anybody online sold him singly. You had to buy a full set of the figures that Mego was putting out. So in order to get Black Manta, you had to get the full set. And if I remember correctly, when the wave came out, Black Manta wasn't even available, if I remember correctly. And then eventually you could get them in a full set of these 14-inch figures made by Mego. But I don't know, it's very interesting and weird, but it did happen. And for whatever reason, again, don't know if it's Mego, their idea, or maybe it was who they're utilizing in China, who makes the figures and has them shipped over. Maybe they came up with this, or I don't know, we don't know. Maybe Joel from Mego knows. Maybe we'll find out here soon, but nonetheless, right now, the chase figure for the new figures that Mego is doing is Black Manta. He's tough as hell to find, and I've never seen him in stores. I don't think anybody's found him in stores. I don't know. I'm rallying on too much usual, but he's hell tough to find, and he still goes for quite a bit of money on eBay. So let's take a look at Mego's 14-inch Black Manta. And here's the 14-inch Mego Black Manta, the arch enemy of Aquaman. He was first introduced, Black Manta, in the Aquaman comic number 35 in 1967. His first name is David. Apparently his last name is not confirmed, but I've read it's either Hyde or Kane, but they're saying it's not confirmed. Here's a quick shot, by the way, of Black Manta without his mask on before we move on here. As you can see from one of the old comics back in the good old days. Black Manta, how did he become? When he was a kid, he was kidnapped and forced to work on a boat. He was on there for a very long time and went through a lot of abuse. And at some point, you know, he's trying to signal, you know, Aquaman to save him. Never happened. And at some point, you know, he just pretty much gets so fed up with Aquaman not saving him that he wants to go out and kill the guy. So he becomes a big villain of Aquaman. His suit, he did create the suit after he did escape from those bad guys in the ship. He created it. His helmet does allow him to navigate in the dark, like big time. But as far as suit goes, his suit does a lot of things. It allows him to die to extreme deaths. And also, he can get oxygen through his mask. He's got a breathing apparatus, which we'll look at. But his suit does allow him to, he's resistant to bullets and also to really heavy, heavy blows. So one reason why he can fight so well. And it does give him additional strength and speed. So that's not too bad at all. So it keeps him cool, or keeps him warm. And he can dive very, very far down in depths without being crushed by the intense pressures of water. But yeah, pretty badass villain for Aquaman right here. But we're gonna get very, very close on this figure right now and enjoy him. And no, folks, I'm not opening him up because you guys know me. I don't open up a whole lot of my figures. I'm not opening this guy. But let's get a closer look on Mego's 14-inch Black Manta. On the top of the box, we have the Mego logo. Marty Abrams presents Mego, as you can see. All right, here we got a great shot of the head sculpt for Black Manta. Looks great with his evil red eyes bearing down on you. Too damn cool. We get into his outfit. His outfit is basically just a diving suit, a black diving suit. And there's his breathing apparatus. This part here does strap onto his back, and then the tubes connect to his helmet. And there you can see he's got a black belt on him right behind the apparatus there, or the tubes. A better shot of the apparatus that he has. And going down is the Mego sticker that they've put on almost all their figures. All right, I say that there's one figure they have not put the sticker on. And if you guys know what figure Mego did not put this lovely sticker on, leave a comment down below. See who knows first. And I'm not sure how well it's coming through on your side of YouTube, but this one is numbered 105. My sticker is very shimmery. I think much more than normal, but yes, I got a really low number, guys. I was very, very happy to receive it. 105, so happy. 14 inch action figure, 14 points of articulation. And there we have the Marty Abrams Presents Mego logo and the Black Manta logo and DC as well. Super cool, super awesome. Looks cool. He does have boots, folks, by the way. His boots are the same boots, I believe, that Superman and Batman have. Looks awesome. Very, very simple figure, but the guy wore a diving suit, a wetsuit basically, a black wetsuit. So how much more do you want? That's a classic look for Black Manta. Let's take a look at the side of the box. Again, we have the Mego logo. Moving down, we have Black Manta, some DC art. Too bad he didn't come with those weapons. That'd have been awesome. And then moving down, again, Black Manta, information again about the figure. The other side is basically the same, but it's in red. As you guys can see, too cool. So we'll switch to the back, get maybe some more information about Black Manta Mego figure. Moving down, there's some more of the 4-inch figures that you can collect. Aquaman, and Batman, and Superman. There he is, Marty Abrams, our Lord and Savior for Mego. And here we go, down at the bottom is information I know a lot of you guys want to see, is who's responsible for this figure. Well, as usual, the consultant is Dr. Mego. Couple sculptors, more than one. We have Sean Sampson, Cynthia Wood, and Annie Cobalt this time. And then the seamstress is Nicole Wilson. It is not Rachel Baker. That's interesting. That's okay. Maybe give Rachel a little break. She probably needs it. So very, very cool. There is the back of the box. The most amazing part of the figure, right, is the back of the box. Gotta get far out, guys, for this damn figure. It's so tall. So we'll flip him back around one more time so you can see him. So hopefully Mego is able to get him back out for everybody to buy. I know my good buddy MIB Master Toy Museum really wants one bad, and I'm sure if he can get, you know, two or three, he'd do it. And it's not a bad idea, being the fact that this is a chase figure. You never know, it might stay as a chase figure. I mean, will it, guys? Will it stay as a chase figure? I don't know. But we'll find out here soon. Hopefully next year in 2020, we'll start seeing the 14-inch figures again from Mego, and finally maybe get that Dracula, that Frankenstein that we all want, and maybe some other 14-inch figures that Mego can do. But so cool. The Black Manta. I'm going to display him right next to my Aquaman figure. So there you go, guys. The 14-inch Black Manta chase figure by Mego. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed taking a look at the new MIGO 14-inch Black Manta. That's right, if you can find it. Hopefully, when MIGO starts producing the 14-inch figures again here very soon, maybe he will pop up and he will not be so hard to find. Don't know, we'll see, but for whatever reason, he is a chase figure, and the one and only chase figure right now for MIGO, just because he's so elusive, I can't find him. But anyway, guys, let me know what you guys think about Black Manta down in the comments below, and maybe any other MIGO figures or any other DC figures, whatever you like to put in the comments would be great. As always, guys, don't stop collecting and have a great day.